it can actually be one. 10 gram of urea, the osmotic pressure is taken as P2, and 10 gram of sucrose, this osmotic pressure is taken as P3, are dissolved in 250 ml of water. Then, what is the relation of these three compounds with respect to their osmotic pressure? The given compounds are, one is glucose, C6H12O6. Second compound is urea. Urea is NH2CO NH2, and its partial pressure, osmotic pressure is P2. And the last compound is sucrose, C12H22O11, and it is osmotic pressure is P3. The relation of osmotic pressure with respect to molecular mass is, osmotic pressure is directly proportional to number of particles, right? As the number of particles increases, osmotic pressure increases. Okay. The mass of glucose given as 10 grams and the mass of urea is 10 grams and the mass of sucrose is also 10 grams. So now calculate the mass with respect to molecular mass. Molecular mass of glucose is 180. Molecular mass of urea is 16. And molecular mass of sucrose is, we have calculated in the last classes, that is 342. Okay, fine. Number of moles decides the number of particles. We know that when number of moles, n is equal to 1, number of particles present are Avogadro number, correct? If you divide the mass by molecular mass, 10 by 180, 10 by 180, sorry, 60, and 10 by 180. Actually, really, you need not to find out the exact number of moles. Simply, you can guess which mass of the substance gives more fraction moles. Okay, 10 by 180 can be written as approximately 1 by 80. This is 1 by 6. And this is approximately 1 by 34.2. And it is inversely proportional. As the denominator increases, number of moles decreases. Least value in the denominator is for urea. Correct? Right?
Yes, sir.
And therefore the value is more. So I can say that 1 by 6 number of moles is greater than 1 by 18, which is greater than 1 over 34.2. Correct? So the number of particles present in 10 gram of urea is greater than the number of molecules present in 10 gram of glucose. Therefore, osmotic pressure exerted by urea is maximum, that is highest. And the decreasing order is P2 is the part osmotic pressure exerted by urea, which is greater than the osmotic pressure exerted by glucose, and which is greater than osmotic pressure exerted by sucrose. So this way we can calculate the mass number with respect to osmotic pressure, diminishing boiling point, diminishing freezing point, and also you can correlate diminishing with osmotic pressure. So the correct answer is third choice. Okay, fine. Now the overall summary of this question explanation gives answer for the next question in a single sentence. Just now I said that osmotic pressure is directly proportional to the osmotic pressure in the solution increases as the number of solid particles in the solution increases. So second choice is the answer. Okay, next question. 3% aqueous solution of dextrose, molecular mass is given. Dextrose is another name for